make of it?
Wind rising, force 5. Heavy weather, sir. We'll have to lighten the boat.
We've caught us a gale, sir.
Cookie, you've been under sail. You've handled dories.
Yes, sir. Give me younger days.
Can this boat make it?
She could make it come wind or water, sir. If you lightened her. She's a seaworthy skiff, sir.
All hands. What I am going to say is not pleasant. What I am going to do is not pleasant. Now I want your attention.
Don't listen to Kelly. Don't listen to him. He's dead. He's all gone.
You all heard Mr. Kelly.
Kelly was out of his mind, Alec. He was crazy with pain.
I found him very sane. Mr. Kelly asked whether all of us should drown or whether some should go over the side so that others may survive.
There is a man.
It's a terrible responsibility, Alec.
I don't like this.
It's the law of the sea, General. I don't like it either, but it's always been women and children first. Some of us men will take our chances in the sea to give the women a chance in the boat.
Negative.
What did you say, sir?
Negative. It will not be women and children first.
But you just can't throw an unconscious woman overboard.
I'm about to issue the order.
I won't obey it, Captain.
I will take full responsibility.
Negative.
There will be no negative.
Negative, negative. I warn you, Alec, it won't work.
It's jungle law.
It's the only civilized way to save us.
Civilized. The whole point of civilization is for the strong to protect the weak.
We're past that. We're in the last extremity.
Women were always shielded and sheltered back in the day of paternalism. What we're seeing today is the same thing, but with the state playing the husband's role, yet getting other men to pay for their metaphorical concubines. As long as government refuses to stay out of things, men have no real chance in the mating game, but men will be forced to continue to support women, one way or another, through tax dollars, support payments, and loss of educational opportunities and jobs to women due to quotas. Now if women had less money to spend, as a result of not stealing funds in divorce and cohabitation breakups, you may think that those women would be in poverty. However, if the support payment laws were to be removed, then most women would stay in meal ticket relationships instead of abandoning them. This would result in less tax funds for the government because women, under the current system, get jobs for money on top of their payments in order to compensate for the extra costs involved in having a second household. The government wants to keep women happy, send them out there to work, and paying taxes. It's a simple pimp and prostitute relationship. Men's productivity and average wages have significantly gone down because of this, due to women taking too many jobs and men seeing that being productive to support a family doesn't pay off, particularly after going through the family court ripoff. The country is now stuck when it comes to what can be done about the dwindling population levels, while the government is also forced to submit to giving women more expensive privileges and programs in order to get them to have children, get their votes, get their tax dollars, and to graspingly stay in power. The state wants women to see them as their new husband, the new alpha male to follow and be led by, as their generous new protector. These are the memes the state has in place. Little do women know that the government just wants to screw up their personal lives for more revenue. Luckily, for the state, women are dumb and certainly greedy enough to be easily convinced it's best for them. On top of that, the hardcore feminists are pushing things for their own decadent reasons, and other women just follow them like flies attracted to shit. It reminds me of the old fairy tales with evil queens, witches, and stepmothers messing with kids. In the story of Rapunzel, for example, the witch takes the baby girl away from the mother and keeps her in a tall tower. When the prince tries to rescue her, the witch blinds the prince and tosses the girl out. I'm afraid these stories wouldn't sell these days because they are not PC, yet were popular in the past, when people knew better about the female nature. In our modern times, women couldn't hack the responsibility of true equality, yet still demanded equality, so they pushed for things like palimony, child support for their illegitimate bastards, job quotas, etc., to make up for it at men's expense. An obvious example is that women want the right to vote but not the responsibility to be drafted and go off to war, and they've done this down the line of female privileges and usurpation when it comes to not having to pull their own weight, nor even take full responsibility for their actions, while getting others to pay and even die for them. It's just more examples of women doubling down and demanding progressive equality whenever they have something to gain, and reverting to the good old benefits of traditionalism, special treatment, and marriage whenever it suits them. Some years ago it used to be that significantly more men wanted to get married than women, now significantly more women want to get married than men. But without the incentive of their divorce option and monetary theft, a lot of women just wouldn't get married in the first place. It looks like men are figuring out that it's not worth it, and women are getting more desperate to get married, although they'll still have their fun riding the cock carousel in their youth. Women's value, at least as wives, is decreasing more and more. The legal risks, divorce rates, likelihood of getting STDs, and the particular problems of marriage actually comes up a negative value when it comes to marriage for men. However, women have no intention of relinquishing their political and legal sovereignty to plunder their exes at will. Not to mention that women are just letting themselves go, personality and looks wise, because it's easy to find sex partners since there are still plenty of guys out there who will fuck anything that moves. With easy sex, easy jobs bringing in money, and easily getting support from their exes or government sources, there's little reason for them to bother to look good. Women are noticeably getting fatter and uglier each year. Of course, a lot of women would like men to man up, particularly financially. However, since women pouring into the workforce has lowered wages and pushed many men out of white-collar jobs into blue, causing greater competition for jobs there, men make about 70% of what they used to make compared to costs back in the day, so that's another inhibitor for men. What makes it worse is that the price of pussy has gone up since women have many other sources of income and sex than in the past, so they're going to be even more picky. So really, it's women that actually need to man up and be realistic if they're looking for stable relationships. In the meantime, the damsel knights, or career-type women, will eventually become extinct. These women, and genetically strong enough to be so, are having fewer kids than the rest. The women who prioritize work over home won't be around for too many generations. One thing's for sure, we're going to see a dramatic decline in populations and genetic quality within a few generations. Until then, population levels will hold up as people get older and live on, but once those generations die, I predict a speedy decline in populations and the extinction of certain genetic types. The working, career women are having fewer kids and will become extinct, and the traditionalist males will also become extinct, leading to an unrepairable dilemma, certainly leading to the fall of civilization as we know it. In short, women will require paternalism, male utility and resources to survive, but there won't be enough men willing to provide it. It would be interesting to go into the future and see how things worked out. with the genetic offspring of a significant number of uncaring clowns and thugs, combined with weaker women who have run out of providers, all hell will break loose.